Hi guys, welcome to engineeringtalks.com. In this video, I'll be dealing with the topic Laplace transforms from engineering mathematics. First, we'll go through the introduction and make the concepts clear, and later on, we'll start solving the problems. So, happy learning. Laplace transform is an effective method by which differential equations can be converted into algebraic equations. But why do we need such a conversion for solving the problem? Why don't we directly solve the differential equations? This is because by using these transforms, hard complicated problems can be transformed into simple algebraic equations. That is, we can simplify the problem and we can solve the problem in less amount of time. That's it's comparatively less time consuming. There are three steps involved in solving problems using Laplace transforms. The first step will be to convert the given hard problem or differential equation in T space into a simple equation or subsidiary equation in S space by taking the Laplace transform. Now, the second step will be to solve the subsidiary equation in S space by algebraic manipulations to get the solution in S space. But we want the solution in T space. So, we have to back transform this solution in S space so that we get the solution of the given problem in T space. So, how can this back transformation be performed? This can be done by taking the inverse Laplace transform. This concept will be clear to you once we start solving the problems. These are some more advantages of using Laplace transforms. It enables us to solve initial value problems directly without any need for determining a general solution. Usually, when we solve an initial value problem, we'll have to first determine a general solution and then apply the initial boundary conditions given to arrive at the solution. But when we use Laplace transform, we can obtain the solution directly and we can skip this step. Next, it enables us to solve non-homogeneous differential equations directly without finding out the solution of corresponding homogeneous equation. The general form of solution for non-homogeneous differential equation is given here. Y equal to CF plus PI, where CF is a complementary function and PI is a particular integral. This complementary function is the solution of the corresponding homogeneous equation. When we use Laplace transform, we can skip these two steps for finding out this complementary function and particular integral, and we can directly obtain the solution. I'll explain these two concepts with examples after we start solving the problems. You should also know the applications of Laplace transforms. It is used in the analysis of electrical and electronic circuits. It is used for finding out the transfer functions of thermal systems, hydraulic systems, pneumatic systems, etc. I'll deal with this topic in a separate video. Now let's define it. Let f of t be a function of t defined for all positive values of t. Then Laplace transform of f of t can be given by Laplace of f of t equal to integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt, provided the integral exists and s is a parameter which may be real or complex number. So this L is known as the Laplace operator. Laplace of f of t is given by capital F of s, which is equal to small f bar of s. Therefore, f of t equal to Laplace inverse of capital F of s, which is equal to Laplace inverse of small f bar of s. Now, what are the conditions for the existence of Laplace transforms? For that, the function f of t has to be piecewise continuous and it must be of exponential order. So how do we say if a function is piecewise continuous or not? A function f is said to be piecewise continuous on the interval ab if this interval can be broken into a number of sub-intervals like t0, t1, t2 up to tn such that the function f is continuous in each of these open sub-intervals, that is ti, ti plus 1 for I varies from 0 to n minus 1. So what do you mean by open subintervals? That is, we may not consider the endpoints A and B here. We may consider only these sub-intervals, and in this sub-interval, the function has to be continuous and must have a finite value. Piecewise continuous functions also display jump discontinuities. That is, we'll have a function that jumps from one location to another at a certain point. And that property is known as jump discontinuity. So we'll consider an example here. Okay, the function f of s is given by x plus 1 when x less than minus 1 and x plus 4 when x greater than or equal to minus 1. These two equations represent the behaviors of the function when x is less than minus 1 and when x becomes greater than minus 1. So let's consider the first equation, x plus 1 when x less than minus 1. So let's consider the values of x which are less than minus 1. Let's consider minus 2. F of minus 2 will be minus 2 plus 1 equal to minus 1. This we can directly substitute in the place of x and we can get the values. Next, let's consider minus 3. F of minus 3 will be equal to minus 3 plus 1 equal to minus 2. And so on. Now let's consider the next equation, x plus 4, when x greater than or equal to minus 1. So when x equal to minus 1, we'll get the value of function as minus 1 plus 4 equal to 3. And when x equal to 0, we'll get the value of the function as 0 plus 4 equal to 4. And when x equal to 1, we'll get the value of the function as 5, and so on. These are the two behaviors we get after plotting these values. This is the behavior when f of x equal to x plus 1, and this is the behavior when f of x equal to x plus 4. And here at this point minus 1, we can see the jump of the function from this position to this position. And we can see from this position onwards, the function even behaves differently. So this is what is meant by jump discontinuity. I already told you the conditions for the existence of Laplace transforms. That is, the function must be piecewise continuous and the function must be of exponential order. Now, a function is said to be of exponential order if there exist constants m and c such that mod f of t is less than or equal to m e raised to ct for sufficiently large t. Any polynomial is of exponential order. Now, we'll see an example. We know the general expansion for e raised to t, that is 1 plus t by 1 factorial plus t square by 2 factorial plus etc. And for e raised to at, we have the expansion as 1 plus at by 1 factorial plus a square t square by 2 factorial plus a cube t cube by 3 factorial plus etc. So we can generalize this expansion using this expression, that is summation n equal to 0 to infinity t raised to n a raised to n by n factorial, right? Now we can write this expression and we know that this expression will be greater than t raised to n a raised to n by n factorial. It's obvious. So we can take these two terms to the side and we'll get t raised to n is less than or equal to n factorial by a raised to n e raised to at. And this is of the form m e raised to ct. Isn't it? So this function is of exponential order. Now let's learn how to take the Laplace transforms of the functions. We'll start with the simplest function, that is 1. Laplace of f of t equal to, we know, integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Now we'll substitute 1 in the place of f of t. So integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into 1 dt, which gives you integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st dt. Now we have to take the integral of e raised to minus st, which will be e raised to minus st by minus s. And we can apply the limits from 0 to infinity. Now we'll take this minus 1 out. So minus 1 by s into e raised to minus infinity minus e raised to 0. Now, you should know the values of e raised to minus infinity, e raised to infinity and e raised to 0. E raised to minus infinity is 1 by e raised to infinity, which is 1 by infinity equal to 0. And e raised to infinity is infinity, and any number raised to 0 is 1. So, we'll have minus 1 by s into e raised to minus infinity is 0 and e raised to 0 is 1. So, this gives you minus 1. So, it will be minus 1 by s into minus 1. 1 by s. So, Laplace of f of t equal to Laplace of 1, which is equal to 1 by s. I will upload another video, which will be the continuation of this. In that, we can solve more problems. If you liked and understood the concepts dealt in this video, please like it, share it, subscribe it, and press the bell icon. Thank you.